Happy Friday! Happy Friday! Happy Friday! Happy Friday! Come on, join in with me. Happy Friday! For us 9-to-5ers, Monday through Friday, this the last day of the week. Week is here, we're gonna have some fun. Or just relax. No, okay, whatever. Okay, that was my attempt at doing the damn internet, you scary. Just make up something, hey, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't rhyme nothing with Akara or according or whatever, because it's hard. How y'all doing? This is Friday. And you would think I'd be so ecstatic that it's Friday. But honey, okay? No, this is the beginning of, whoa, because my manager is out for the next couple of weeks getting her vacation in, and I'm so happy for her, but that means more work for me. Uh-oh, I thought I could go. That means a lot of work for me because I am one of the team leaders, and it's only me and another young lady who is a team leader as well. But it's just us. It's three team leaders. And the other one, who is like a credit to humanity, man. because she's been at my, been where I work for longer than me, so she knows a lot. I've only been there for 2 years now. So, well, actually, technically, three. So, yeah. So that means I'm gonna be around. I'll stay until someone leaves. That means questions will come to me. And what I need to do is going to be delayed because I have to be open to questions, and helping and assisting and so forth. So, I got up early and logged in at home so that, okay. Woohoo! All right. I logged in at home. Thank you, Lord, for helping me see that so I know to put on brakes and move over and do what I need to do. Because trust me, I'm good only by His grace. So, today, as you could probably tell, I have on my hoodie. And you probably can't see me because that light is shining. Ooh, like my future. shining bright like my future. Hello. Ooh, it's been a while since I left out this late. Well, this late in dealing with the rush hour traffic. Everybody's on the road. Let me turn the camera on so you can see what I'm talking about. See all that? See all that? See all that? Yeah. See all that? Thank God for the side road. It might help me out just a tinch. Just a tinch. It might help me by going on this side road. Ah, fuck this. I am not. That traffic is too crazy. Not. No. okay. I'm trying to see if I'm in the right boulevard that I want to go. Yeah, this is, I'm in the right lane. So, yeah. Sister said, no. No. I will get off and ride the street. Hello. Because everybody want to be on the road on Friday. People supposed to be taking off. But anyway, you see I have on my hoodie, my Vegas hoodie. Because it's chilly. Now, I'm going to tell you honestly, I'm not a fan of cold weather. I don't like snow. I don't want to say I don't like snow. Like a fresh snow. On a Friday morning. So I don't have to go to work. Enough snow to shut it down. Oh, you don't have to go to work, girl. I am in the wrong one. I'm at the wrong one. But all is well. I just realized I'm on the wrong one. I'm on the wrong street. But I think I can work it. I think I can work this. I think I can work it. I love y'all, but I'm going straight. I love y'all because I needed to turn right and I was in the wrong lane. I said, forget you. And I just really need to get off on the next exit anyway. So, well, not the very next exit, but the exit after that. So I'm like, yeah, just go ahead, go straight. I was trying to avoid that traffic on the highway. But, I mean, had I turned the right way and got on Memorial Drive, I'd have been straight. But I was about to turn and go in the wrong direction. By the way, if you can't tell, I have a great memory, but horrible direction. You know, like, wait a minute, hold up. You know, like, GPS was the best thing that ever happened to me. Okay? GPS is the best thing that ever happened to this chick here. Okay? It is the best thing that ever happened to me because my directions. Sometimes I need direction to take me around the corner. But let me do it 2 to 3 times consistently. Bitch. I got it. I remember you. I remember it. But just put me here and say go east, you know, or whatever. It looks like, you can't tell that this is the, no. And I'm not ashamed. Everybody has their strengths and their weaknesses. So, anyway, outside that it is Friday, September 10th. I'm going to tell you a little bit about my first shot journey. So, now this is the third day since getting my initial shot. Yesterday I felt good enough to actually eat more heavier foods when I got home. Now, mind you, it wasn't that I didn't have a taste to eat or didn't feel like eating. It's just that my stomach was a little queasy, or what they call nauseous. I was a little nauseous. Well, you know, just didn't feel, you know, I didn't really want to eat lest it just comes out in diarrhea, or I was afraid that it was going to come back up. And that I had that feeling for the first day till about yesterday. Yesterday evening, I felt good to eat, you know. To eat dinner, you know, some chicken and some cabbage. Still came out with the runs, but It was more coagulated than on Tuesday. Can we say that? But my stomach didn't feel queasy. But I did have a light lunch of French fries again, which I wanted it for the salt. And plus, they smell so good. Somebody in my office got French fries yesterday. And it smelled so good, but I felt like it was a good something to put on my stomach while I worked. You know what I'm saying? Yesterday, it was quick to eat. I can eat it at my desk. And, you know, it had the salt that helped settle my stomach. So, that was good. So today, you know, I feel like, I don't know if it's because of the shot, that I feel like I'm about to come on my period and I'm about to have cramps, but no. Now, you know, like I said, I'll be out here doing the vax that thing up, okay? Vax that ass up dance if a few things happen. One, I get superpowers. I want telekinesis. If I'm correct, that's when you move things with your mind. Super speed and super healing. Like, you cut me and that cut heals up immediately. You know what I'm saying? You shoot me, the bullet, you know, I heal immediately and the bullet pops out. You know what I'm saying? Or bulletproof. Or my skin can't be permeated like the Hulk. You know what I'm saying? That would be good. I mean, like, I get superpowers. So I get superpowers. I lose weight. And it fixed the high blood pressure and the, like, it fixed any ailments I have in my body. So, healing. You know, no high blood pressure. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that type of thing. I'd be like, vax the thing up. Gotta vax the thing up. Child, let. Child, please. Superpowers. And, that type of superpower. You know. Have the power to touch computers and make them do things. You know what I'm saying? That type of thing. Heck yeah. Oh boy, but yeah, so now let me lose some weight, some, you know, significant weight, healthy. Like, when I say lose weight, I'm talking about got bit by a spider, woke up with a six pack, okay, type of lose weight, get in shape. You know what I'm saying? I'd be the poster kid for that daggone vaccination. You hear me? But so far, so good. This is, like I said, I felt like I was coming on, but like like I was about to cramp. Like, only those who have suffered from severe cramps or continual cramps throughout their cycle will understand what I'm talking about. You know that feeling that it's like, oh, you know, but it's been chilly out. It's a 68 degrees outside. Well, when I walked out, it felt a little chillier than that, probably closer to 60. Not in the 60s, but closer to 60. So I put on my hoodie. So this car don't know where they're going. One day I'm just going to have me a dash cam and just record how some of these people be driving in Atlanta and probably reveal how I drive in Atlanta. I'm a grandma compared to some of my friends and family. So today, the end of yesterday and today is the first day where I don't feel queasy. So that's what it is, and I'm expecting, I'm praying that it'll only get better, and that the when I get the second shot at the end of the month, I didn't even like feeling like I'm about to vomit. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I would say the other thing that would have me doing that Vax That Thang Up song, dancing, and being a poster kid is if it stops my period. Oh, it kicks me into menopause. I'm like, girl. Or even shorten it. I mean, you know what I'm saying? If it shorten it and lightens it, because I have, and I know this is TMI to any guy that's watching this, so, you know, deal with it. I'm a woman. I'm just saying. I am a heavy flow, and I cramp bad. It could be debilitating at times, where, you know, I just want to lay in the bed, and people don't understand it if you don't deal with it, but they take that, and no cramps. Well, I've grown attached to my cramps. You know, not the debilitating shit where, like, I've had cramps so bad that I vomited. I've had cramps so bad that I vomit. So, not that bad, but, you know, my cramps kind of, they're only on the first day. So, if I didn't have cramps, I can't gauge my, you know what I'm saying? I know when she's coming through. I know when Aunt Flo is about to stomp the yard, you know what I'm saying? You know, so, cramps without bleeding. I don't really want that, because that means it could just come on at any time. You know what I'm saying? I need that cue to say, oh, okay. You know, some type of cue in my body that, oh, she's coming. And when I feel a certain way, I know that she's on her way. And plus, my period, for the most part, is like clockwork now, you know? Maybe it's always been like clockwork, because I guess now that I'm older, I know how to count. Okay, the last period was here. It could come anytime between this date and that date, you know? So I'm more into counting when to expect my cycle. That's why, you know, but then again, not everybody have a, you know, cycle that is on time. And it could be just that I'm older and my eggs is old, is geriatric eggs, these old eggs. It's like, look, you know, we go to bed at 6. My Aunt Flo is old too. So, and when you get older, you do things on time. You know, you don't feel the need to do a whole bunch of stuff. Now, I'm not saying that I'm timely. Like, I need an employer, and I'm thankful that I have one that isn't on my back for not being exact on time every day. But then again, when I was temping, I was early, but I also wasn't driving in. So, I had to go according to the bus schedule, and the bus schedule that got me there on time got me there early, because anything after that, I'd be significantly late. So, I just thank God for that. And I'm not always on time, especially when it comes to events. So if you ever invite me to a birthday party or something like that, I'm not coming. I don't like getting especially to places where I don't really know the person. I mean, like, I only know them in general. I don't like getting there early. I'm going to be honest with you. I hate being there early because then it's the awkward conversation. I honestly don't like getting places like that, events and stuff like that, early. I want people to be there. I'm the fashionably late person. I'm the one who like to be fashionably late, even though it's not fashionable. It's not due to fashion. It's just that I like people to be there. And I've come into this just recently, though, honestly. I like people to be there so it's easier for me to slip in and slip out. You know what I'm saying? So, as you can tell, I'm pretty much don't have nothing, and I'm just kind of rambling on and just talking about whatever. Slow it down. I am about to my destination right now, and I'm gonna let y'all go so y'all can enjoy your Fridays. I pray that your Friday is easy and light, unlike mine's. I pray that my Friday is lighter than normal, okay, than expected. You know what I'm saying? People leave on time. They do their jobs well. I pray that you do your job well. Your employer is extra nice, and something really, 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 really good happens to you today. Okay? So, that's all, folks. Bye. Remember Auntie's telling you, love yourself, love your neighbors, and stay authentic.